able to see, right? Anyone
Yes,
able to
ma'am.
see this? Yes. You're able to see.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then the last classes we have started with the second module, and we have seen what are the access controls. We have looked about the access control, that is that is first one is default, private, public, and protected. Then we have started with not only Java access modifiers, we have non-access modifiers. So that is static, final, abstract, synchronized, and volatile. And we have seen how those access levels are applicable. So then we have started with passing objects to a method. Then we have seen a program. In the same way, parameters and arguments, how the parameters are passed and how the arguments. So this program we have seen only for the string, and only one parameter is passed. So then multiple, if I want to send the more number of parameters. So this is one program, then we call string name of the particular person, then as well as age. So here we are passing two parameters. So that's the reason it is called as a multi-parameter. Then returning objects from method. So here we return the objects, that is twice the object. Then we have seen about a method overloading. And we have started with constructor overloading. So then we have seen differences between methods and the constructors in Java. Then we have started with recursion, and we have seen one program called as a Fibonacci series. And we have started with static, what is a static and what is nested classes. And we have seen the static can be used for variable, method, blocks, or nested classes. And we have started with the static, what is a static Java static variable. So then what is static method? So then restriction for the static methods. So then Java static block, then Java inner class, the syntax for inner class. So we have seen what is outer and what is inner class. Then we have seen about the advantages of Java inner class. Then types of nested class we have seen. So in that, the member inner class, anonymous inner class, local inner class we have seen, and static nested classes. So then these are the types, that is member inner class, anonymous inner class, local inner class, the static nested class, and the nested interface. Then we have started with a variable length argument. So I was saying that what's the difference between union and structure. So you people gave me the answer saying that union will take a memory allocation, whichever the variable having a maximum size. So that is the similar like here also. So the variable length argument. So then we have seen one program for that. And we've started with inheritance. So what is inheritance? Inheritance is, someone has come, I have to allow them. What is happening there? Okay, so what is inheritance? Inheritance means acquiring the properties of base class to the derived class is called as an inheritance. And so why use inheritance in Java? So inheritance is one of the building block of object-oriented programming language. It allows creation of classes with hierarchical relationship among them. Using inheritance, one can create a general class that defines trait common to a set of related items. Why use Java? Why we want to use Java inheritance in Java? For the two main reasons why we require Java inheritance in Java is, first one is method overloading. So runtime polymorphism can be achieved. So what is this runtime polymorphism? Poly means what? Many forms. So that's what here we can achieve. Same way how we have seen overloading, here we have a method overriding. And one more main thing why we require inheritance is code reusability. Suppose if you are into a company and you have done some project and you have done one method, in one project, let us say one small package or some small class, some functionality you have done in one project, and you have been completed that project and you are moving on to the next project. So then the same logic you have to use some place in your project. So instead of writing in from a scratch, what you can do it, you'll be using the same thing in your code. So then that is what is called as a code reusability. So what are the terms we use in the inheritance? First one is a class. A class is a group of objects which have common properties. It is a template or blueprint from which objects are created. Then what is subclass or a child class? A subclass is a class which inherits the other class. It is also called a derived class, extended class, or a child class. Superclass or parent class. Superclass is the class from where a subclass inherits the feature. It is also called a base class or a parent class. And reusability, as the name specifies, reusability is the mechanism which facilitates you to reuse the fields and methods of the existing class when you create a new class. You can use the same field and method already defined in the previous class. So what are the terms we are using in the inheritance? The first one is a class. A class is a group of objects which have a common properties. It is a template or a blueprint from which objects are created. Subclass or a child class. A subclass is a class which inherits the other class. It is also called a derived class, extended class, or a child class. So it is subclass. Sometimes some people call it as a subclass, some people call it as a child class, some people call it as a derived class, some people call it extended class. Everything is fine. So subclass is a class which inherits the other class. It is also called a derived class, extended class, or a child class. Superclass, parent class. A superclass is the class from where a subclass inherits the feature. It is also called a base class or a parent class. So then what do we call the base class or a parent class? A superclass is a class from where a subclass inherits the feature. It is also called a base class or a parent class. The reusability, as the name specifies, reusability is the mechanism which facilitates you to reuse the fields and methods of existing class when you create a new class. You can use the same field and methods already defined in the previous class. So superclass, some people call it as a superclass, some people call it as a parent class, some people call base class. It's one and the same. All those having the same name. And superclass is a class from where a subclass inherits the feature. It is also called a base class or a parent class. Then reusability, as the name specifies, reusability is a mechanism which facilitates you to reuse the fields and methods of existing class. When you create a new class, you can use the same field and methods already defined in the previous class. So reusability, I gave you just example. As the name specifies, reusability is a mechanism which facilitates you to reuse the fields and methods of the existing class when you create a new class. You can use the same fields and methods already defined in the previous class. So in Java, inheritance is achieved using the keyword extends. So what is the syntax for inheritance? In Java, inheritance is achieved using a keyword extends. The syntax is given below, that is class A, that is a superclass. The member of a class A, when class B extends A, that is subclass. So members of B. So class A, so you can see here. So what we are doing, what is a keyword? This is one class. The name of the class is A. And this A is called as a superclass, parent class, base class, is one and the same. A is a base class. And B is a derived class. What is this derived class? We want some properties from A to B. So then we are using a derived class. So in that case, So how to take these properties to this class? So we are using a keyword called as a extends. So from where? From A. A class B extends A, that is subclass. So that's what your class B, class A and class B. Java inheritance example. So what we have done, so you can see here the example for that employee and programmer. Here salary, it is a floating, they've taken programmer, it is a bonus. As displayed in the figure, programmer is subclass and employee is a superclass. The relationship between the two classes is programmer is a relationship. It means the program is a type of the employee. So this is a base class, this is a employee. So in now let us take same concept with the BMSIT college. In BMSIT college, there are so many employees. Again, in that employees also, there are so many people, like HOD, principal, staff, then again, housekeeping, security. There are so many people. So that's what main class, we are calling it as employee. And again, in that, we can take anything, but in this example, we have taken it as a programmer. Okay, so next coming to a first program. So let us see one program for inheritance. So class employee, then float salary. So salary is fixed to the 40,000. Then class programmer extends employee, int a bonus equals to 10,000. Then public static void main string and argument. So then what we are doing in this, a salary is fixed to 40,000. So the salary, employee salary fixed for 40,000 and programmer class extend in the bonus for that is 10,000. So then public static void main, I just told you for any program, we have compulsory have public static void main that particular line. Then programmer P equals to new programmer. Then system.out.println programmer salary, P dot salary. Then system.out.println bonus of the programmer, that is P dot bonus. So we can see here how this P is a object created for a derived class. And the employee, we have a salary. And we want to use the salary also in our program and we don't want to display it. So that's this is very simple thing. Then we have used a extends the employee in the programmer. So that's what here in this program. So employee is a base class, programmer is a derived class. And in employee, we have one variable called as a salary and the data type is a float and the value for that is 40,000. Then class programmer extends employee, int bonus, that is 10,000, public static void main, string arguments, then P programmer P equals to new programmer. So that's what we have created a object called as a P. Then system.out.println programmer salary is P dot salary. System.out.println bonus of the programmer is P dot bonus.
Excuse me, so
that's what here
which
we can
line
see.
Are you expecting? It's a difference
yes?
between
yes?
Java constructor and Java
yes?
method actually.
Yes, Navya.
Ma'am,
yes,
which
Navya?
Slide are you showing, ma'am, actually?
Tail style,
and Navya. Break.
Hello, ma'am.
Style.
Am I audible?
No, Navya, I'm not able to hear you what you're saying. Yes, Navya, you want to say something?
Ma'am, your slides are not changing.
Voice is not clear.
Ma'am, the slide which you are explaining is different and the one you are presenting is different, ma'am.
Yes, Navya. Someone was saying something. My voice is not clear. Hello. Can anyone respond? What is the problem? I didn't hear. Ma'am, slide is not matching. Oh, it's not moving. Okay, then I'll stop and reshare. See, that's a problem. I have just shared as window, but it is not taking
care. No, slide size that killer. Avagin angle.
Yes, Kaushik. Okay. At least now, now you are able to move. See the scrolling of the.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So we have started with inheritance. We are using inheritance in Java, that is method overriding and the code reusability. The terms used in inheritance: class, subclass, a child class, then superclass or a parent class, and reusability. So in Java, inheritance is achieved using the keyword extents. The syntax is given as below, that is class A and class B. And taking one example, employee and a programmer. So employee is a base class, programmer is a derived class. So then they've started with two classes. One class called as a employee. Employee is a base class. And float salary 40,000. So then this is a base class. Then class programmer extends employee. So this is here we are using a bonus as 10,000. Then public static void main, that is string. Then programmer p equals to new programmer. System.out.println. Programmer salary is p.salary. System.out.println. Bonus of the program is p.bonus. So here what we are doing, salary is printed and bonus is also printed. Okay, let us take one more program and see how this simple inheritance is working. So you can see in class A, we are taking int variables I and j and data type as int. So then we are taking one method called as a show method. We are taking a method as a show method where we are just displaying a I and j. So then class B, so class A is a base class, class B is a derived class, and we want I and j to be displayed even in a derived class. Then we are using class B extends A. So that's what here, class B extends A. So int k void, so we just want to display what is k, so we have displayed k. Then we want to add all I, j and k. So the sum, we are calling it as one more function as sum. So then we are adding I plus j plus k. So what we have done, this is a base class, this is a derived class. Still the program is not complete because there is no main method here. And we take main method here. So class simple inheritance, public static void main string. So and we are creating a object, we are creating a super object for a class A, and we are creating one more object for a derived class with a B. So then we are passing a I and j value 10, 20, because I and j are in a base class, and we will just display the super class what are the values in I and j. Then we are taking a values, different values in subclass for 7 and 8, and for k we are taking 9. So that is the contents of subclass. Then we'll display what is there in ij and what is there in k. It is in a subclass, not superclass. And we are adding all of them and display them here. So can anyone say what will be the output of this program? Can anyone say what is the output of this program? Yes. Can anyone? Okay. So here in this case, because here we are adding I, J, K, and the values for subclass, we have passed at 7, 8, 9. All these will be added and the sum will be displayed. Okay. So next we move on to types of inheritance. What are the different types of inheritance we have? We have a single inheritance. If a class is inherited from one parent class, then it is known as a single inheritance. This will be of the form as shown below, that is superclass and a subclass. So
So the previous program is an example of single inheritance. We have just seen this is a class, one base class and one subclass. So then such type of program is called as a single inheritance. So that is an example of a single inheritance. What is this type of inheritance? This is a single, where we have only one parent class and one subclass, then we are calling it as a inheritance. Let us take one more example. So here we have an animal. So where the animal is a base class, and in that animal we have a method called as a eat system dot out. We are just printing in a eat method as a eating. Okay, then we have coming for a derived class, that is dog. Then that extends a base class, that is animal. Dog is a derived class, and white. So the people keep coming. I have to admit them. It becomes very difficult for me to go back, come back, coming, going. Yes, please come in time. Okay. So class animal, void eating. Eating is in a base class, and class dog, it is in a derived class. And we want to extend a base class to a derived class, then we are using a dog. And in the derived method also, derived class also, we have a method called as a bark. So even that, just displaying it as a barking. Okay, then the main class. So here we are just using a test inheritance and public static void main. And we are creating a object for a derived class, that is dog. Dog D. So we are creating D as an object name and calling a method dog. So D equals to new dog, and we are calling both the methods using an object dog. So D dot bark and D dot eat. So that's the reason we can see the output. First is barking, because we have called first method as bark, then we have called it as a base method, so eating. So that's how here the output of this program, and this is very simple program, and this program shows us a single inheritance. Single inheritance class, it is a base class, it is a class animal, then void eat system dot out dot println eating. So then class dog extends animal, void bark. There's a point. Okay. So class animal, this is a base class. Dog, it is a inherited, this is a base and this is a derived class. So void eat system dot out dot println, that is eating. Class dog extends animal, void bark system dot out dot println, that is barking. So then class test inheritance, public static void main, string arguments, the dog D equals to new dog, D dot bark, D dot eat. So that's how here animal, dog and inheritance. So that's how here bark and eating is the output of this program. So next we move on to the multi-level inheritance. So in several classes, are inherited one after the other in the hierarchical manner. So it is known as a multi-level inheritance. We can see in this program, A is a class and B is a derived class. And again, B becomes a base class and C becomes a derived class. Again, C is a base class and D is a derived class. This is what is called as a multi-level. One is A is a base for B, and B becomes a derived for A. And again, B is a base class for C. C becomes a derived class. And D is a last derived class. C is a base class for a D. Okay, let us see one small program. Again, the same program, what we have seen, continuation of that. So class animal is a base class. and in that we have used a method called as a eat. So the same way class dog, it is a animal, is a base class. Dog is a derived class. Okay, now again in that dog, we in dogs also have a baby dog. So in that again, baby dog is a derived class for dog. Now dog becomes a base class for baby dog. So that's how this is a multi-level. So animal, again dog, again baby dog. So here we have a three classes. One is animal, dog. For animal, dog is a derived class. For dog, for baby dog, dog is a base class. So like this, dog acts both. It acts as a both a base class as well as a derived class. Baby dog is a last class, that is a derived class. So again, in this, eating is a method which is present in the base class of animal. Then bark is present in the class called as a dog. And weeping, it is present in a baby dog. So these are the three methods in the respective classes, that is in animal, dog, and baby dog. Animal is a base class. Dog acts as both derived as well as base class. And in that, what is the method we have? We have a bark. And in a baby dog, that is a last derived class from a dog. So you can see, we are using the extinct keywords. So we want animal to be extended to dog. In the same way, dog should be extended for a baby dog. So that's how here we are using a keyword called as an extent. So then test inheritance, public static void, main string arguments. So then we are creating one object called as a D, baby dog equals to new baby dog, D dot weep, D dot bark, D dot eat. So that's what here, weep, bark, and eat are the methods in the In this example shows us a multi-level inheritance, that is weep, bark, and eat. So that is class animal, dog, and a baby dog. So then why do we require a multiple inheritance? Multiple, so you should know what is the difference between multi-level and multiple. So why multiple inheritance is not supported in Java? Can anyone answer why multiple inheritance? At least say me, what is the difference between multi-level and multiple? Can anyone? What's the difference?
Multiple means a class is derived using two multiple base class, whereas multi-level is class is derived from the previous class which is already derived by the other base class.
Okay, correct. So multi-level is, so what you can see in the picture, it has base class, derived class, base class, derived class. But multiple means I may have two parents, three parents, parent classes, then all those properties are taken in the child class. So then that is called as a multiple. So why that is not allowed in Java is, so let us first consider one scenario, then we'll be able to understand. Consider a scenario where A, B, and C are three classes. So that's what here I have one A class, B class, and C class. And the C class inherits properties from two parents, that is A and B class. If A and B have the same method and you call it from a child class object, there will be ambiguity to call the method of A or B. So suppose if we say that, we have three classes, A, B, and C. A, B are parent class. C is a child class. And in A and B, there is same methods. And C wants to take values from both the things. So then the child will be in a confusion. Child class will be in a confusion saying that which one I have to take, whether I have to take a method from A or whether I have to take method from B. So then that situation, even the compiler also will not be in a position to take which properties it has to take, whether a A class property or a B class property. So then the compiler also will be giving us an error. So that's what here, since compile time error are better than runtime error, Java renders compile time error if you inherit two classes. So whether you have same method or different, there will be compile time error. Printing hello. So we have one more class called as a B, where there also we have a message, and in that we are printing it as a welcome. So then class C extends A comma B. So then suppose if it were, so then public static void main, that is main string arguments. So then we are creating an object for a derived class, so that is OBG, and here we are calling it as a C. So we know that C is a derived class, and we are calling the C. We are extending both A as well as B, and in A and B also both the message function is there. Message function is there. In one A class, a message is hello. In B class, the message is welcome. Okay. So then now we have created one object for C. Subclass, and we want to display object dot message. Okay, then which message the compiler has to take, whether it has to take welcome or hello? Yes, can anyone answer? So which one the compiler should take? Object dot message we have, which one it has to take? Because in A class also it has message, B class also it has message, and C is taking both A and B. Whether hello will be printed or welcome will be printed out of for this program?
Hello will be printed.
Hello will be printed. Why not welcome? Welcome is also there. We have taken, right? C extends A comma B.
Yes, ma'am. It will go in the prescribed order, ma'am. So A will come.
No, this is just for our order, but this compiler will not have all these order. Compiler will start from main. Okay.
Main, after that it will go on top, no ma'am.
No. So here, can anyone else say whether you'll get the output as hello or welcome?
Ma'am, first it will print hello, then welcome.
Anyone else?
Yes, ma'am. First it will print hello. After that, next line it will print welcome.
Okay. So then you people have not understood properly what is multiple inheritance. So here multiple inheritance is what? Now, the compiler, which message it has to take, whether message method, message for from this or message from this? So there is a conflict here. The message in Java, it will not give us which message should the C class should take. So it has confusion. Should it takes from a parent A or parent B? So that is it will not execute this. There will be an error in this program. So there will be a compiler error. Why? Because multiple inheritance is not allowed. Yes. So multiple inheritance is not allowed in Java. That is the example here. So considering a scenario A, B, C, and there are three classes, and C has inherited A and B class. That's what in our program also, C is inherited A, B. And if A and B class have the same method, yes, we have a same method, that is message and message. So then, same method, you call it from a child object. Yes, we have called from a child object. So child is C, and we have created an object for that, and we are displaying a object dot message. So if from child object, there will be ambiguity to call the method of A or B class. since compile time error are better than runtime error, Java renders compile time error if you inherit two classes. So that's what here, this is not allowed, this part is not allowed in Java. This is a, what it will give us is, it will give a error. So that's what is called as a multiple. So you should know what is the difference between multi-level and multiple. So here this example is for multiple. So multiple, why? Because there are two base classes, A and B. C is a derived class. This one is not allowed. So this part, what we have taken A comma B, is not allowed in Java. So when it is not allowed, this program will give us an error, because there is a conflict which message it has to display, whether it has to display well hello or whether it has to display welcome from C. Because C, we are created an object for C. From C, we are calling message function. So which message C has to take, whether A message or B message. So this is a problem here. So then this, that's the reason why multiple inheritance is not supported in Java. Okay, next topic is member classes and inheritance. So I'll just stop here. We'll continue this in the next class. So before we stop, so we have started with inheritance. We have done yesterday with the variable length argument, and today we have started with inheritance. So what is inheritance? Inheritance is one of the building block of object-oriented programming language. It allows creation of class within a hierarchical relation among them. Using inheritance, one can create a general class that defines traits common to a set of related items. So then why using inheritance in Java? Why should we use inheritance? There are two main reasons why we have to use. That is a method overriding. We will see them what it is. So method overriding and code reusability. So these are the two reasons why we require a code reusable. Why we require a inheritance in Java. What are the terms we are using in Java? In Java, in inheritance, we are using a class, subclass. What is a class? The class is a group of objects which have common properties. It is a template or a blueprint from which objects are created. Then subclass or a child class. A subclass is a class which inherits the other class. It is also called a derived class, extended class, or child class. Then superclass, a parent class. A superclass is a class from where a subclass inherits the features. It is also called as a base class or a parent class. Then reusability, as the name specifies, reusability is a mechanism which facilitates you to reuse the field and the methods of existing class. When you create a new class, you can use the same field and methods already defined in the previous class. So this is an example or a syntax for Java inheritance. So A is a base class, or some people call it as a super class, some people call it as a parent class, all are one and the same. So class A is a base class, and class B is a derived class or a subclass. So we want the properties from A to be taken in B. So then what we have to use, we have to use a extends keywords. Class B extends A. So class A, member of class A. So class B extends A. So A is a base class, B is a derived class. And we are extending a A to B. Okay, here the inheritance example, here the employee and a program. So in BMSIT college, we have so many employees. So there may be some employee, and in that we have taken one method called as a salary, which is having a 40,000. And we have a derived class called as a programmer, extends employees, that is bonus is 10,000 rupees. Then public static void main, that is string, So then programmer P equals to new programmer. We have created an object for a derived class P. And using a derived class, we are printing P dot salary, then P dot bonus. So that's what here salary and bonus will be printed. This is one example, very, very simple example for employee. So the same way, let us take one more one where class A, class B. Class A is a base class and class B is a derived class. Class A, we are using two variables as well as one method. So what are the variables we have taken of data type int INJ and method is show IJ. So here INJ is printed. The same way B is a derived class and it extends A. So int K, then take show K, that is system.out.println, that is K. So then sum system.out.println, we are adding I plus J plus K, I plus J plus K, add all these and display. That's there in the sum. So that is what is a show. So here we are creating a simple thing and we are creating two objects, one for base class, one for derived class. So for base class, we are passing 10, 20 and printing them here. And in the same way for derived class, we are passing 7, 8 and 9, we are printing them. So print IJ and IJ is from a, you can see what is this, show IJ is in a base class. Show K is in a derived class. So we are first displaying them what is there in IJ. Then we are changing the value of IJ in a derived class from 10, 20 to 7 and 8. And display first, display of base class is here. And again, using a derived class object, we are displaying a show IJ, then K. So what is K value we have? We have a 9 here. And what we are doing in show K, we are just displaying a K. And finally, we are displaying a sum. So what is a addition of, that is what we have done here, addition of I plus J plus K. So we are adding all the three. That's what here we are displaying. Then we have started with types of inheritance, that is single inheritance. Single inheritance means only one base class and a derived class. Then we call it as a single inheritance. Single inheritance in the class is inherited from one parent class. It is then known as a single inheritance. This will be of the form as shown below, that is superclass and a subclass. The previous program is an example of single inheritance. Then class A, so we have taken a base class as animal and eat is one method in a base class. Dog is another method and in that we have taken as a park. And here animal is a base class, dog is a derived class. And we are creating an object for D, that is object D is created for the dog. Then D dot bark and D dot E, then barking and eating. So multi-level inheritance. If several classes are inherited one after the other in the hierarchical manner, it is known as a multi-level inheritance, that is A, B, C, and D. So that's what here, multi-level inheritance. And we have taken the same example with the extended one. Animal is a base class. Dog is a derived class. Again, in term, here dog is a base class for a baby dog class. So eat is a method in animal. Bark is a method is in a dog. Weeping is a method in a baby dog. And displaying all the three, that is first weep is displayed, that is weeping will be displayed. Then bark, next bark will be displayed. And the last one, eating will be displayed. So that's how here first weeping, bark and eating will be displayed in the way which we have taken. So why this multiple inheritance is not allowed or not supported in Java? Because the compiler gets confused in case in two base classes, if you have a same method with the same name. That is, in this example, we have taken a message. So A is also base class, B is also base class. C is a derived class. C is taking both A and B. And because it is taking A and B, And in A and B also with the same name, same methods have a same name, that is message. So then this C will get confused whether it has to take from A or whether it has to take from B. So then this will get confused and it will be in an ambiguous state. So I'll stop here. We'll continue in the next class. This Monday's class. Yes, answer your attendance. Answer your attendance, Anagha.
Yes, ma'am.
Abhilash.
Yes, ma'am.
Akhil. Akhil is present. Akrut.
He is present, ma'am. Network issue.
Anusha.
Yes, ma'am.
Aravind.
Present, ma'am.
Arifullah.
Yes, ma'am.
Benika.
Present, ma'am.
Bhanu Prakash.
Yes, ma'am.
Bhargav.
Yes, ma'am.
Rahmatullah.
Present, ma'am.
Chaitra.
Present, ma'am.
Chandana.
Present, ma'am.
Charan.
Yes, ma'am.
Darshan.
Present, ma'am.
Diksha.
Present, ma'am.
Takshayani.
Present, ma'am.
Kishan.
Present, ma'am.
Harshit.
Present, ma'am.
Hemalata.
Present, ma'am.
Uma.
Present, ma'am.
Jayant.
Present, ma'am.
Divya.
Yes, ma'am.
Kaushik.
Present, ma'am.
Lakshmi. Present. Lavanya. Present. Manish.
Present, ma'am.
Manoj.
Present, ma'am.
Mohit.
Yes, ma'am.
Naval.
Present, ma'am.
Navya.
Present, ma'am.
Nikhil.
Present, ma'am.
Panindra.
Present, ma'am.
Pavan.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, yesterday absent, no, sir?
No, ma'am. Present, network issue.
Pooja.
Present, ma'am.
Purnima.
Yes, ma'am.
Raman.
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi.
Present, ma'am.
Rupak.
Yes, ma'am.
Rupak.
Present, ma'am.
Sai Kumar. Yesterday, sir, last two classes, sir.
Ma'am.
Sai Kumar.
Day before yesterday, I presented them.
Nenne absent, huh? Samir.
Present, ma'am.
Santosh.
Present, ma'am.
Sadab.
Present, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Shashank. Shashank. Sheetal.
Present, ma'am.
Shivani.
Present, ma'am.
Soumya.
Present, ma'am.
Spurti.
Present, ma'am.
Shri Vishnu.
Present, ma'am.
Sugandini.
Present, ma'am.
Sushma.
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita.
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita, you?
Present, ma'am.
Teerta?
Present, ma'am.
Drupti?
Present, ma'am.
Varsha?
Present, ma'am.
Veena?
Present, ma'am.
Okay, we'll stop here and we'll continue in the next class. And I hope so, you people will be knowing that now you have e-utsaha, right? Sir sent you a message. You can join there for the event. So that's the reason I'm leaving you a bit early, 5 minutes early. Okay, thank you. We'll stop here.